So as it said, the written material could be religious or secular. Secular means something different other than any religious matters or doing anything to do with God or anything to do with religion. And there's a writing, the picture type here which we have. It's how much? They're saying it's a 125 year old palm leaf. That just now I said, you say the tar tree or something, on that it is written here. See, so like that. Okay. So books and manuscripts, this is religious literature, all about religion now. Books and manuscripts that deal with religion are referred to religious literature. The Vedas, the epics. What are the main epics? The Ramayana and the Bharata. You are watching Ramayana now on TV, right? You are watching Ramayana on TV every day. It's been given because of the lockdown. So learn, see what happened. You'll come to know how the people used to go around, how the people used to go, how did they use their brains. They did not study much, they didn't have schools, but people learned how gurus gave gyan to their shishyas, how the schools ran, how did the gurukuls go around. Gurukul is a school where the learned person, the seer person, S-E-E-R, seer, who has knowledge, he's not religious but he has got very lot of knowledge. I mean, he's got a vast bank of knowledge inside his head and he's not religious. He sits on the top and there are students sitting below him and listening to him. They used to only listen, there was no writing at that time for them. Upanishads. The Upanishads, the Bhagavad Gita, the Jainangas and the Buddhist Tripitakas are examples of religious literature. These texts help us to understand the religious practices and beliefs and the social and economic life of that period. These books, these epics, the Ramayana, the Mahabharata, you are watching Ramayana on TV, you must have watched Mahabharata also. So watch Ramayana now again and see if you can recollect anything and think how people used to, what was the social and religious life at that time. It's going to help you a lot. It's already in a chapter. Secular literature. Secular literature contains of all those texts that are non-religious, we just now read, such as autobiographies, biographies, and court chronicles, Harsha Charitra, the biography of King Harshavardhana, written by Banabhatta, poems and dramas written by famous writers such as Abhijinana Shakuntalam by Kalidasa, folk tales such as the Panchatantra, works on politics such as Kautilya's Arthashastra, and books on law such as Manusmriti are examples of secular literature. These are all the biographies and autobiographies of King Harshavardhana we get, the famous Kalidasa we get, his folk tales by Abhijanana Shakuntalam, and then we have folk tales by Panchatantra. When I was a kid, I used to read Panchatantra comics, very nice beautiful tales, you know that. I still remember that Panchatantra tale, that monkey sitting on the tree and he's wanting to go that side of the river to meet someone and he's wanting to eat, and the crocodile says, I'll take you there, will you give me this much to eat? I still remember little bits of it, very nice stories. If you download it on Google, you'll get Panchatantra stories, are very nice. They were showing it on TV also in cartoon, in the animated series. Many writers, scholars and traders visited India at various times and wrote about their experience here. The accounts of these foreign travelers form an important historical source. Megasthenes, the Greek ambassador, visited the court of Chandragupta Maurya. He wrote a book called Indica, which gives us valuable information about the Mauryan society. Other important accounts include those given by Chinese travelers Fa Hin and Huin Sang were very famous travelers who have written a lot of biographies and court chronicles, and they have given much more information of in history. They have really contributed to the Indian history, who came to India to study Buddhism and wrote about people, their lifestyles and the society at that time. So we'll finish it till here. We'll keep it till here, and I'll catch you up in the next class again and get those word meanings done. And please go and look up the PDF files and the Y links. There are much more, and try to make your notes. As I've told you, please do put attention and make your notes. We all, the teachers, are really working very hard in getting these videos done for you so that we can keep in touch, and you are in keeping in touch with your books and studying as well. Okay guys, be safe, be home, and take care of yourself, and do whatever you like after you study. Bye bye.